Hello everyone, this is Mahua Sen. Today I'm going to read a poem by Taslima Nasreen. Taslima Nasreen, as you all know, is a Bangladeshi feminist author who was forced out of her country because of her controversial writings, which many Muslims felt discredited Islam. Taslima Nasreen remained in exile after 1994. From Europe, she moved to India in 2004, but her presence was sharply criticized by Islamists there. In 2007, the city of Kolkata erupted into riots as Islamists demanded that she be forced to leave the country. Nasreen then fled to the United States. Throughout these upheavals, she continued to publish autobiography, novels and poetry. Well, according to traditional expectations and values of the society, we all know that women are constantly expected to kind of sacrifice their own personal freedom and happiness for the sake of their husbands, children and the family. However, through the poem Border, which I'm going to read now, Taslima Nasreen reaffirms that the woman as a human being who has duties and responsibilities to her family, but she is also worthy of satisfying her own desires and aspirations. So let me read the poem Border by Taslima Nasreen. I'm going to move ahead. Behind me, my whole family is calling. My child is pulling my sari and my husband stands blocking the door. But I will go. There's nothing ahead but a river. I'll cross. I know how to swim, but they won't let me swim, won't let me cross. There's nothing on the other side of the river but a vast expanse of fields. But I'll touch this emptiness once and run against the wind, whose whooshing sound makes me want to dance. I'll dance someday and then return. I've not played keep away for years as I did in childhood. I'll raise a great commotion playing keep away someday and then return. For years I have not cried with my head in the lap of solitude. I'll cry to my heart's content someday and then I'll return. There's nothing ahead but a river and I know how to swim. Why shouldn't I go? I will go. So this poem is originally written in Bangla. This is the translation of the poem. So in this poem, the speaker is restrained by her husband, forbidding her escape, but also by her duties as a mother and as the nurturer of the family. She realizes that escape will not be easy. She sees it as being quite an obstacle, but she has confidence in her ability to survive and make it on her own. And in the end, you see, the ending of the poem gives the reader a great sense of hope for the speaker. She realizes her oppressed state and desires to kind of get out of it. She knows that she has the capabilities to do so. She also knows her responsibilities to her family, to her husband, to her children. But she does not let that stand in the way of achieving the freedom she has promised herself. So this concern for the self is something very refreshing that is found in Nasreen's poetry. Thank you.